apologies.
Very good.
Turn that asshole to 11.
Thank you.
Listen, there's another armored bus. The dustmen won't stop until everyone's dead.
Thank you. weeks of around-the-clock research, the CDC just announced that it has developed a cure for the Empire City Plague.
Listen,
side
can
effects
you pull
are
some
said
cool
to be quite
moves?
Mild.
I want to take some pictures of you in action.
And the vaccine has a 99% success rate. Officials went on to say the distribution of the cure, administered by a single shot, will begin tomorrow.
Awesome, just need a couple more pictures. Awesome, just need a couple more pictures. Awesome, just need a couple more pictures. Yeah, keep it up. Just need a few more pics. Awesome, just need a couple more pictures. Yeah, keep it up. Just need a few more pics. Awesome, just need a couple more pictures. Awesome, just need a couple more pictures. Dustman destroyed the clinic I had on one of the piers. Go break some bones. Teach him not to come around here.
Thank you.
major blow against the forces of tyranny was struck today as heroic soldiers attacked and destroyed a terrorist-related broadcast facility operating within Empire City. Acting on a tip from a concerned citizen, the soldiers not only destroyed the terrorist broadcasting equipment, they also uncovered evidence that a major terrorist attack was in the final planning stages. Had this attack been carried out, it would have resulted in catastrophic loss of life. I think I speak for all Americans when I extend my heartfelt thanks to the forces.
Look, transients put surveillance devices on my building. Please, you have to disable that junk.
of those armored buses is driving around, shooting everyone in sight.
Looks like Kessler's keeping the ray sphere in the old examiner building. Gonna be a bitch getting to it, though. 78 seconds.
So what's the plan?
I've got a canister of fentanyl rigged to the bottom of the chopper. Should incapacitate everyone inside. Unfortunately, Kessler's got anti-air guns on the surrounding buildings, and they'll tear me apart long before I get into position. 7 seconds.
So I take out the guns, you gas those bastards, and we go in and get the sphere?
Exactly. Now we only get one shot at this. So get over there and destroy those guns.
See those jets, Cole? They're hitting targets all across the city. preparing the way for a ground invasion. I warned you that if I lost control, they'd escalate things. You shouldn't have reneged on our deal.
You're not pinning this on me, Moya.
I already have.
To make another bomb, so this is our only chance. Take out those guns before they blow me out of the sky. As you can. away. Move it!
So I gotta put it down. Get your ass down there and stop them! I'll follow you on foot as soon as I can.
Kessler asked me to hold it while he adjusted some cables during a test. I could feel it pulsing, like something was inside it trying to get out. It's not right.
And everyone wants it.
That big lightning strike of yours should destroy its protective container. Then we can blow the sphere sky high.
How many lives has that thing destroyed, corrupted? I can't risk it falling into the wrong hands. Gave me powers once before. If I use it again, it could make me twice as strong. And then no one would dare challenge me. Trish's crumpled body flashes through my head. I think of Amy, Zeke, and I hit that sphere with everything I've got. But something goes wrong. The race field cracks open, creating a vortex of energy. John's pulled in, and it tears him apart. And I run. John and the race sphere are gone, reduced to ashes. Nothing went according to plan. At least the race sphere is out of the picture.
I'm disappointed, Cole. The race sphere was the catalyst of your powers, and it could have strengthened you even more. But you rejected it. I, for one, wouldn't have done the same thing.
Yeah, well, I'm not like you. It took me a while, but I finally realized that this isn't about me, about what I want. Not anymore.
Seriously.
It's about keeping this city safe. And once you're dead, no one will ever threaten it again.
That remains to be seen. Meet me at the Staten Building.
There after the bomb went off.
I've always been there, Cole. Every step of your life.
You're not worming your way out this time, Kessler.
You're weak. A failure. All of this has been for nothing.
Get your hands off of him! Cole, make a run for it! I'll take care of this gas bag.
This doesn't concern you, fat man. No one is gonna save you this time.
You're not gonna be so glib when I ram my foot up your ass.
This is nothing, Cole. What's coming is much, much worse.
Thank you.
Vision's wallet, telling people she was the daughter he never had. Did you know that? He couldn't wait for you to marry her. Rotten son of a bitch. Kessler, reveling in my victory. And then I heard him whisper, "Trish, I love you. Please forgive me." Then he was on me, fingers digging into my face. As Kessler's secrets played out in my head, I finally began to understand. I saw his nemesis, a beast intent on extinguishing all life. In those early days, Kessler could have used his powers to stop it, but instead he fled with his family, leaving others to fend for themselves. Hunted for years, Kessler and his family watched as the rest of the world went to hell. And then it was too late to fight, too late to save anyone. In that moment of failure and grief, he used his newest and most dangerous power. He went on a one-way trip back in time, attempting to rewrite history. Kessler seized control of the First Sons and accelerated the Raysphere's development. Decades spent plotting the blast, organizing the quarantine, finding me. Yet the thing that drove him forward, Kessler's sole link to the past, was a picture from his wedding day, when he married Trish, with Zeke as his best man. My brain lurched, unable to accept that Kessler and I were the same person, that he'd come back in time to mold me into the savior he failed to be, going so far as to kill the woman he loved, I loved, so that I wouldn't be tied down by emotions. No, Kessler wanted me strong, ruthless, so that when I faced the beast, I'd be capable of making impossible decisions, all for the common good. And then Kessler fell back, dead. His final message, my final message, burned into my brain. I take one last look down at myself, my future self, and turn away, the rage curdling inside. I hate everything about Kessler, but when the time comes, I will be ready.
Thank you.
thought this would be the end. That once Kessler and the Ray Sphere were gone, my life would go back to normal. But now I understand that this is my life. That there's no going back. That the gift of these powers will be my burden until the day I die. The people around here, they love me. How long will that last? What's going to happen the first time they expect me to be there for them and I'm not? I don't even know who to trust. Moya is still running around, planning God knows what. And Zeke, I don't know what to think. I've never been more alone.